Now, let me quickly say this. This topic is very important. It's all about pastors saving yourself, your wife, your children, your family, and saving the world. Now, this is very important. I must say that there's so much to talk about on this, but because of time, I probably like to limit many things. I'll say. Let me just go straight into it. Why are we saying you should save yourself? Save yourselves, save your family, save your wife and children from who? From Satan. I'm just going to go straight into it. Satan has always wanted to destroy you, because your family, your wife, your children, because he sees you as threat. Now, but then you have to try, just like you have always tried, and you have to do your best to stop him from destroying you. How does he do it? Satan always knows that he cannot do much except God gives him the go-ahead. So what he does is that he tries to push people, just like he pushed David in 2 Samuel to number the people. He tries to push pastors to get it wrong and do something that will get God angry. Just like David did in 2 Samuel. So I go and give him go ahead, the angel of destruction, to now come and deal with people. And just like he was after Jerusalem, this time around, he's after you and your children and your wife. And that's why you have to be very, very wise about it. Just like the Bible says in Amos, he said, wise men turn away wrath. Satan is a bad Satan. He likes to get God angry. So that when God is now angry, God will not give. God is a king. God doesn't do anything. God doesn't do evil. God doesn't even the good. When God does it, God sends in your Gabriel to do it. When he's angry, he sends Satan. He doesn't send. He allows Satan. And Satan is a bad Satan. He knows that the only way he can touch people and destroy and kill most times in mass is to get God angry, so that God can give him the go ahead to go and destroy, to kill, to steal and destroy. And most times when God gives him go ahead, it's always after, men of God, just like he is doing now. Just like he, was after Jerusalem the day, he attacked, made David to number the people, and God gave him go ahead to destroy the people. In fact, as a matter of fact, remember the story, he killed almost 20,000 people in 3 days, 70,000 men, the Bible said. Now let me just go straight into the where Satan is now trying to use you now. God revealed this to me. It sounds very religious, but that's the truth, pastors. There's an error that the church has over time, the leadership of the church, pastors, have consistently committed that Satan is taking advantage of. He has always taken advantage of it. For example, let me go straight into it. The teachings that we teach, even before Jesus left. Before Jesus left, he said, go into the world and teach the people what I have taught you. And let me tell you, unfortunately, Satan has never allowed the church and the leadership of the church to settle down, to properly understand and do what Jesus said. Now, Satan has always taken advantage of that, where he now brought Apostle Paul. Apostle Paul now said, this time around, we are under grace. We're not under the law. Let me just summarize by saying this. The only way you have to turn away that rod, because God is not happy. This grace without the law message that the church has preached for a long time has over time degenerated into what we have as democracy, the government of the people, by the people, and for the people. Systematically over the time, Satan has succeeded in using all of us, but to remove God from the equation, where we are not doing our own government and our own system of government without God. God doesn't have a problem with us doing democracy, but the situations where we now put God, remove God out of the situation is a calamity, really. Now let me just say this. Here's it. How do you turn away the rod then? The Bible says in Psalm 3, kiss the Son, lest he be angry and destroy you on the way. Now, quickly, who is the Son? Jesus. How do you kiss the Son then? Teach what he told you to teach. When he was going, he said, go into the world from Jerusalem to Judea to the uttermost part of the world, teaching them the things I have taught you to observe. What are the things, Jesus had taught us? What did he teach us? He taught us the Ten Commandments, which is forever. That is the law. Paul said we're not under the law again. Yeah, we're not under the teachings of Moses. God gave Moses two things, the law and his teachings that comprises of, you know, ordinances, precepts, sacrifices, and judgment. Those are the teachings of Moses. The law is the Ten Commandments. Sacrifices, judgment, and all those things are the teachings of Moses. In Christianity, we are still under the same law, Ten Commandments. But we are not under the teachings of Moses. We're not under sacrifices of Moses. We're not under, so Apostle Paul got that part right. But you see, he didn't understand that God gave Moses, you know, the law, which is the Ten Commandments. Jesus said it. That rich man that went to Jesus, he said, what will I do to enter the kingdom of God? Jesus said, do you know the law? The man said, which ones? Jesus said, Ten Commandments. You can see that that's the law. The church is meant to preach the law. So that all this problem we have in our society, for example, the church has not been teaching Ten Commandments anymore. And many, that's one of the problems that a lot of countries, particularly Nigeria, is having now. Now, look at lawlessness everywhere. Now, if the church teaches Ten Commandments as much as emphasizing it, all the government officials that are stealing money and are covering it with lies, which is probably corruption. Corruption is when you steal and you're not covering it with lie. Now, our government officials, many of these people are in our churches. If the church keeps teaching Ten Commandments and emphasizing it, then what we have in situations like what we have in Nigeria will not happen, where the government officials are not doing their job. They are embezzling money, the money that is meant for youth development. Now look at our youth now that have turned miserable because the government is not providing anything. All the money that's supposed to use to provide youth employment, everything, employment for the youth, they have embezzled and they have sent their own children abroad. Now look at our youth now. They have turned miserable. Our boys are now doing serious fraud. A typical, an average young man in Nigeria now is a Yahoo person. He's doing fraud and he's been fetish, killing girls, using girls. Now, quickly, girls too have turned to lucro because there's no point. They're turned to prostitute. They don't have money. Many of their parents are not even employed. So you see, this lawlessness has now turned into serious trouble in society. That's why the church must respond to the law. The law is the Ten Commandments, like Jesus said. Then every pastor must now teach alongside the first thing in the law, Ten Commandments, that shall not kill. Look at killings everywhere now. Because of this lack of preaching of the law, because now we are preaching grace without the law. Now, unfortunately, this lawlessness now has now affected every area of our lives. You know? Now people are killing anyhow. And if you teach this Ten Commandments, pastors, turn this rot away. Because when God is angry, these things are getting God angry. All these killings, all this corruption, all this unemployment that is causing our youth to be miserable and be fraudulent and use that fetish, using all these boys are ritualists, using girls, and girls are becoming prostitutes. All these disruptions are really getting God angry. And you know when God is angry, Satan is happy. He's actually emphasizing and taking advantage of this gospel of grace without the law. So, pastors, please turn away this rot. Because when God is angry, he gives Satan the opportunity to go and carry out their anger. And Satan is coming for you guys. This is something that God revealed to me, and I have to quickly tell you, pastors. You do your job. Teach the people Ten Commandments every time we gather. That's the plan. Because of our new nature that we got from the fruit, every human being has the ability to lie, to kill, to steal. So God said, teach these people, if possible, write it on your doorpost. Pastors, please, teach these Ten Commandments. Because churches are not teaching Ten Commandments again. God doesn't have a problem with us building buildings, but God is not interested in all the 100,000 capacity we are bringing. It's not a bad thing. But if you must build these buildings, first of all, take the law and emphasize it. If every church is teaching the Ten Commandments, the country will be better because all these government officials, they are in our churches. When we teach it, emphasize it, don't steal, don't lie. Those two, stealing and lying, we erase corruption completely. Then don't kill, all these things, please. Now, quickly, they now teach the teachings of Jesus. That's why every pastor is supposed to be studying Jesus. Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. That is your area of specialization. Just like a Muslim cleric and imam will study and teach Prophet Muhammad, a pastor should study and teach Jesus. And what is Jesus? Jesus said, you know, just like he told the young rich man, he said, do you know the law? The man said, which ones? He said, Ten Commandments. That's number one. You teach Ten Commandments as a pastor. They know the teachings of Jesus, particularly the one on the Mount of Olives, starting from Matthew chapter 5 to chapter 7. Now, if you must teach Apostle Paul, you teach 90% of Jesus first, because Apostle Paul too, God used him, you know, God gave him some revelations. Now, take 7% of Paul, 90% of Jesus, 7% of Paul, then 2% of all the apostles, Peter and all of them put together, then 1% of whatever revelation God has given you. But the foundation must be 90% Jesus. If we pass us, this is the way you can turn away the rod. Like the Bible says, kiss the Son. Who is the Son? Jesus. And the only way you can kiss the Son is to do what he said. Follow what Jesus said when he was going. He said, go and teach the people all over the world, from Jerusalem to Judea, to the uttermost part of the world, the things I have taught you. What has he taught us? The Ten Commandments, number one, and all his teachings. If you teach this thing, you will turn the rot away. Just like the Bible says, wise men turneth away the rot. Pastors, don't say because people don't like these teachings. I know people don't like it, but you teach it. Save your family. Because when God is angry, God told Ezekiel. He said when he's fully angry, he said the righteousness of Job, of Samuel, of good people like Moses will not even cover for their children. In fact, God was so angry that God even killed Ezekiel. He allowed Satan to kill Ezekiel's son. And Satan knows God that when God is angry, he will allow him to do crazy things. See, let us turn away the wrath of God. God is angry. All these problems we see around. Look at Satan now. When God is angry with the world because of all the lawlessness we have around, which is as a result of this law, this grace without the law message we are preaching everywhere. See, God has not allowed Satan now just to attack us one. Satan is the one attacking us. Can you see the plague called coronavirus? Do you know that he has killed almost 4 million people all over the world now? Don't allow Satan to kill you, pastors. Please, teach, kiss the Son. That's the way to turn away the rot, just like the Bible says. Kiss the Son. How do you kiss the Son? Please, teach what Jesus told us to teach when he was going. Matthew chapter 7, the verse 28 or thereabout. He said, go into the world, teaching them the things I've taught you to teach. Go into the world, from Jerusalem to Judea, to the uttermost part of the world, teaching them the things I've told you to teach. What has he taught us? The Ten Commandments and his teachings, particularly the one on the Mount of Olives, chapter 5 to chapter 7 of Matthew. Do 90% of that. If you must teach Paul, thank God for him. He had revelations. Teach 7% of Paul. Then teach 2% of all the apostles to put together. Then leave 1% for yourself if God gives you revelation. Please turn away the rot. God bless you.